people would say, save your money. You know, the young, you don't want to hear that. They say, save your money for a rainy day. I said, shit, it's raining today. I'm about to go get me a Ferrari.
I came home early from the road. I had a $12,000 suit on, because life's been going good. And I got home early, and dinner was cooking. You ever come home when dinner's cooking? Doesn't that smell good? And my son saw me, and he was like, Dad's home. And he got up from the table and ran over to give me a hug, but he had chicken grease all over his face. So I stiffed on him like, yo, my man. Wash these threads, son. This is an expensive suit. I don't want you to get the chicken grease all over me. And he was like, what the chicken grease? Dad, this is duck. A tear came out of my eyes. I never dreamt I'd do so well in life that I'd raise a nigga with duck grease all over his face.
My wife actually beat me up, made me take her on a date. Took her to a dinner party. I'm not a name dropper, but this joke doesn't make sense unless I drop the name. I went to Seinfeld's house for a dinner party. Some of the best food I've ever had. Food's fucking amazing, man. At the end of the dinner party, Seinfeld came walking out. He was like, nobody go anywhere. You guys are in for a treat. Tonight, we're gonna have some brick oven pizza. Everybody went crazy in the party. What? Oh my God, brick oven pizza? What? One lady was like, how many cheeses, Jerry? Jerry was like, seven different cheeses. People went crazy. By the way, all these people were white. These are all fucking white people. They start chanting, bop, 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 bop. The fuck is bop, man? Bop, bop, bop. What the fuck is bop? White woman leaned over the table. She was like, it's short for brick oven pizza. I was like, oh, shit. Oh, okay, I get it. Seinfeld has some Italian men walk out. They had pizza-like garb on. They start passing out the pizza saying Italian shit. I don't know Italian. It just dawned on me, actually, as I told that joke. What I'm doing is racist right now. I apologize. People were eating the fucking pizza going crazy. Oh, my God, I taste the cheeses, Jerry. I taste the cheeses. They bought me my piece of pizza. I took a bite. I couldn't fucking believe it. Best pizza I've ever had in my life. Best fucking pizza I've ever had. Had some type of lettuce on it. I've never tasted this shit. Tell my white baby's got some type of lettuce on it. Wait till you taste the lettuce. This white woman, she leaned over again. She was like, it's arugula. What? It's arugula. Oh, shit. I took another bite. I got caught up. Bop, bop, bop. Bop, bop.
Get money now? That fucking feels good. Man, oh, my God. Oh, my God. Like, going from broke to having shit is so exciting, you know? I started Ubering everywhere. Woo! Feeling like a goddamn prince. I don't give a fuck. I don't care if I'm getting out the back of a Kia Sophia, nigga. I'm a king. Step out like Eddie Murphy coming to America. Stepping on roses petals and shit. But I got fucked up. I got broke for a week and I had to Uber pool. I was broke for a week because when you first start getting money, you fuck it up immediately. You don't know what you're doing. So I was broke for a whole week and had the Uber pool. Oh my God, it was terrible. Because when I first started Uber and I was so excited because I was like, I'm not broke no more, I'm off the bus. I'm not with these broke bus niggas, you know? I'm free. And then I had the Uber pool and I was like, damn, this just a little ass bus. This just a bus where niggas are closer to you than they would be on the actual bus. This is garbage. Sucks, man, to be in the back eating and shit, having full conversations. You try to turn your whole body to the window so you don't make eye contact. I figured out how to beat Uber pool though, man. Way you beat Uber pool is you ride in the front. It's the way to defeat that shit because then you don't feel as low because then it's like we picking niggas up. Then you just riding with your homie, pulling up on niggas like, hey cuz, get in.
Honesty is a motherfucker. You gotta stop being honest. I'm gonna let you know, I've had some miraculous moments in my life just from being honest. Why? Because you never know what another motherfucker's into until you being honest with them, right? It brings out the extraordinariness in you, definitely. One day I got a speeding ticket from this cop, fine in a motherfucker. She gave me the ticket. I'm like, damn. She was like, what's wrong? I was like, I wish I could get out this ticket. And she was like, well, what you talking about? And I was like, well, Now, I was about to crack a joke and be on some old goofy shit, but my mom was like, you already got the ticket. You ain't got nothing else to lose. You might as well be honest. I was like, well, I was thinking maybe I can take you to dinner and then go eat your pussy all night. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know, just a suggestion, I don't know. Guess what she said? Follow me. And I was like, thank you, Jesus. Oh, that was all God's glory on that. Not only did I get some ass, but I saved money.
I like to sit in the shower. And so, it's tough. I do recommend it. Don't look like that. Sitting in the shower is perfect. Sitting in the shower is great for when it's like, you want to be clean, but you want to rest. Do you know what I mean? I love it. I just sit down, honey, because I don't want to stew, you know, like a bath. I don't like that stewing. So you just sit down, you relax, and then you just have this water falling on you, just sort of. And it feels like you're in a 90s R&B video. And that's beautiful. That's romantic. Just for yourself.
I can't compete with these otherworldly wheatgrass-infused bitches, okay? Because I'm not an otherworldly wheatgrass-infused bitch. I'm just... banter and ass, okay? Yeah, banter and ass. And I try and change myself, you know, like exercise and stuff and, you know, work out and get healthy. And I try and exercise and work out and get healthy, but I can't because I'm perfect, okay? I can't do that shit because I'm fucking perfect. I'm fucking perfect. When I put on weight in my stomach, so much so that if you go to Google and type in, is London Hughes, the first thing that comes up is pregnant, okay? My mom showed me that fucking bitch, right? That is the truth. And like, I put on weight in my stomach area. Some people call this a food baby. I don't call it a food baby. I call this a wealth gut. This is a wealth gut. This means you can afford brunch. It's a wealth gut. Henry VIII had one, I'm fine, okay? It's a wealth gut. Ceviche, Taco Tuesday.
The City of Angels. I love every moment, man. I'm enjoying myself. I just got back from vacation, so I'm having a great time. You know when you got that vacation swag? You know, you still got that thing, you know? You still feel loose, you feel relaxed. I went to Bali on vacation, yeah? Out in Indonesia, yeah? If you've never been, make a plan and get out there. It's an amazing place. I went out with some of my friends, learned a few things about myself as a person. Most important thing I learned is somebody needs to invent a TripAdvisor specifically for black people, right? No, because just generally I find that what white people want to do on vacation is what black people are trying to escape. And not in a bad way, it's just like we want different things out of life, you know? Like my white friends always inviting me camping, for instance, always. Like with enthusiasm, we're all like, Trevor, you want to go camping, dude? I'm like, why? Why? It's like, dude, what do you mean why? It's amazing. You're kidding me? It's like no water, no electricity, you know? It's just like us in the great outdoors. You gotta take a dump in the like in the hole in the floor or something, dude. I'm like, yeah, that was my life. That was me growing up. You know how hard I worked to never go camping again? Every day
I wake up in my bed and I'm like, thank God I'm not camping.
Whatever you guys want, I want that for you. I wish for whatever you want, okay? I don't think we don't do that enough. And I really want whatever you want. I don't really have any wishes or wants anymore, like not with this current administration, let's be honest. But I do have one teeny tiny wish that I want to speak into fruition. I really want Meghan Markle to let herself go. Do it, girl! You did it! Like, wear your hair curly. Wear a blousy t-shirt. Wear a heeled sneaker. Get wild, Megan. Get wild and comfortable. But I secretly and selfishly want Meghan Markle to let herself go so I could play her in The Crown. Oh my God, I'd be so good at it. Are you serious? I'd make The Crown so fucking edgy. Oh my God, I'd be in the corner of Buckingham Palace getting my hair braided. Sucking on a chicken bone, pouring frosé on someone's titties, being like, I'm a queen too, bitch, and what? Ooh, I make The Crown so edgy. I want a sex scene with Harry. I want a sex scene with Harry. I'd suck his ginger dick. I would suck his ginger dick now. I would. I would. You'd suck it too, bitch. Don't act like you wouldn't. I would suck that ginger dick. The episode would be called Ginger Snap. I thought about it.
People, you know, people would say, save your money. You know, the young, you don't want to hear that. They say, save your money for a rainy day. I said, shit, it's raining today. I'm about to go get me a Ferrari. Shit. I'm about to go have some fun. I was doing crazy stuff, y'all. I was doing crazy stuff. I bought two houses right next door to each other. Just crazy. I was my own next door neighbor. It was crazy. I was borrowing stuff for myself and shit. I mean, you got some sugar we can borrow? You know I got some sugar we can borrow. What you talking about? You, me, and I'm you, man. Go on up there and get it. I mean, you ain't got to talk to me like that. Damn, dude. I ain't want to be rude. I was going to ask you, damn. You don't act like that, as long as I've been knowing you. Crazy, man. I'm cutting back, though, now. I'm saving my money. I'm smart. Getting smart with my money. I ain't doing that, buying no all these houses no more. Smart. Me, Toni Braxton, and Jermaine Dupri getting an apartment together. And Tara Owens moving in too with us.
So I was on this flight once and I was wearing a nameplate necklace that says my name, Nicole. It's only 6 letters long, but it takes up my whole chest. My best friend had it made for me in Brooklyn, and the jeweler was like, are you sure you want it that big? She said, yes. I have a very tacky friend. So I was wearing this necklace on a flight, and the flight attendant comes over and said, oh, well, you must be Nicole. I said, yeah, my necklace. He goes, yeah, but I also recognize you from Girl Code. I think you're very funny. And it is always so nice when someone says they like your work and they think you're funny, because half the time you're like, I don't know if anybody likes me or thinks I'm funny. And according to Reddit, they don't. So the flight attendant says to me, do you want a drink? I said, yes, please. May I have a vodka soda? And he said, I got you, I got you, I got you. I was like, then go get it. What are we doing? So he goes and he brings me 3 of those little airplane bottles of vodka and a splash of soda, and I said, game on. So I drink that, he comes back around, he says, do you want another? And I said, yes, please. So he brings 3 more, no soda, and I said, we're doing it. So I drink that, he comes back around, he says, do you want another? And I said, I don't know how to say no. So he brings me 3 more. If you nice people are counting along, that is 9 of those airplane bottles of vodka on a 4.5-hour red eye. Everyone is sleeping and I'm the drunkest I've ever been. I was sitting in my seat and I was like, what if I roll around in the aisle? Imagine I got up to lay down to roll in the aisle. What would that call to ground control be? We gotta land this plane. This big black bitch won't sit down. But then I was like, I know what I will do. I will not roll in the aisle. I will watch Back to the Future. So I watched Back to the Future like I had never seen it before. I was knee slapping and tee-hee-heeing. I was 3 inches from the monitor. I was like, Marty and Doc's age difference is pretty wild. And is Lorraine ever okay? And, and then we land at JFK and it's 7 a.m. and Shake Shack is open. So I say out loud to no one, Jesus loves his little baby.